Hello, Raj. Raj, wake up. What? You've still gotten over last night's match or what?
Oh yeah, how can you get over that, man? I mean, it was
Are
sort of
you hungover?
it was seriously hungover.
Not because of Friday night hijinks.
That didn't happen. That didn't happen, unfortunately. But the match was so boring that I sort of dozed off here. So I
Sort
put
of. Which is
it.
good because a lot of us in here, we actually nodded off totally.
So, I mean, any idea
Yes, boring match. It
what
was a
KKR was
boring
trying to do? I mean, amongst all this mess, what was it? We had Dinesh Karthik saying he's quitting captaincy, and then
match. Exactly. See,
after all of
as
that.
a captain, that is a courageous decision. Everything is fine, accepted. He has put the team's interest ahead of his own personal interest, and he is. It is good that he has decided to focus on his batting, which is all fine. But when a captain quits midway, it also reflects there is a huge confusion within the ranks as a team. That's very simple. So, and it was pretty much evident on the performance last night. On the, I mean, KKR didn't. I mean, not only the old captain didn't turn up as captain, the team itself, in a sense, didn't turn up. In a manner of speaking.
So, I mean, see, honestly speaking, I mean, yesterday we were having fun at what Virendra Sehwag said, right? I mean, Sehwag had a point when he said, see, none of the batsmen, the top five, I mean, if you can give Andre Russell the benefit of the doubt, because he
No.
who had to take away the bouncer from
Because
his
that was sheer brilliance of Bumrah.
head. Although he could still have ducked, he moved first. So Sehwag had a point. I was watching it again. I mean, he actually moved into the bouncer. I mean, instead of moving away from the bouncer, and he was not prepared for it. Which probably is the reason,
Just to interject, because Bishop had a very good point on air, because this is not my point, this is something which Ian Bishop said. Even the balls, two balls prior to that, Andre Russell was moving towards the left, which the boundary that he hit was from the after having moved to his leg side, Andre Russell. And the delivery after to the delivery that was after that was also he moved to his left. So Bumrah spotted it and went for his bouncer, followed him up, and that is where his smartness lay. That is what, I mean, it was not something which happened. Bumrah
See, again,
clearly
Bala, I
spotted
am saying
that
Bumrah was right, Russell was wrong. That's what I'm saying.
Exactly.
See,
Yeah,
Russell
that's
was
right.
wrong because he didn't know how to handle that ball. I mean, he could have easily handled it if he was actually he had his wits about him. That is what
Yeah,
Sehwag
if he
meant.
has stayed stationary.
Yes, and he wits about him. See, when you are moving
Yeah,
back, you sort of don't do this. You don't move
right.
front.
And the periscope
You
was
move
up.
back. Yeah, and the periscope was up.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that was Sehwag's point. It is not up that Bumrah was not clever. Bumrah was clever. I mean, he actually
And he
got
is
that wicket.
mostly clever. He is mostly
Yes.
clever.
So for me, the other guys were, I mean, see, like you said, no, Karthik, I mean, was responsible enough to quit captaincy. But what was the shot he played? I mean, why was he playing that shot in the first place? You are talking about what? Karthik got
He
out
was
in.
trying to be too cute. Too
Yeah.
cute. He got out of the delivery immediately after Shubman Gill's
Yeah,
dismissal.
eighth over, you lose
It
two
was.
wickets. Shubman Gill has also had a very middling sort of season. I mean, we need to accept that now. I mean, I've been watching this, I've been saying this. He's been having a middling this thing. He's not as brilliant as he was last year. Something obviously is not
See,
working.
everyone says he is one of the slow. I mean, apart from Finch, he is among the openers. He has had the lowest strike rate.
Yeah. So, I mean, what is happening is that maybe that is the role they have given to him. Maybe it is a way.
That is the role. But the problem is, see, it's a good point that you bring up. That may be the role that they have earmarked for him. The problem is, he had a consistent opening partner. He has had three opening partners: Rahul Tripathi, Sunil Narine, and Tom Banton. So three openers. So none of them have gotten going at the other end. So that has put added pressure to Gill
Yeah,
because
possible.
he's not. So that is a problem because you don't change so many openers. I don't think so. Any other team has had three different openers.
And yesterday also, they seem to be playing a proper Brendan McCullum brand of cricket where you need to score whatever happens. I mean, everybody was trying to come and score. Now, I mean, it didn't look like they had any idea. See, I mean, I remember the way Nitish Rana got out. Shubman Gill got
then ordered. Then again, he's also a huge product. He has had four single-digit scores.
Yeah.
So your one batsman cannot afford to have such a lean rod in such a tournament.
Yeah. So that is he's had a problem. So I really think KKR is, I think, looking at a bigger scenario. I mean, yesterday's match, I don't think there is anything we need to say about Mumbai Indians. They came, they saw, they conquered, not conquered. When you use a KO and
KO,
conquered. I mean, they conquered and went away. 16th over the match, 16th, 17th over, the match was done and dusted. So, which is a lesson for a lot of other players, other teams, right?
Other teams,
yeah.
Especially Punjab and Chennai.
Yeah. So, going deep is all fine, but the point is, if you have an option, finish it
if
off.
If you have your opponent on the mat, might as well
stomp over them, finish it off. It serves you. So which is
and it also helps that you have a settled unit. I was just reading, then again, this is something I read on one of those sites. Mumbai has had only 13 players so far in the tournament, which shows how a settled unit that the team is right now, which is amazing. And one of the changes is what we saw last night.
Yeah.
Which is they bought Nathan Coulter-Lyle in place of the James Pattinson.
See that,
and another was due to injury. So they had a very settled.
Oh, the unit. Other? I thought there was only one. No?
They had totally 13, not exactly. So overall, tournament they were.
Okay. Oh, no, you meant that. I thought yesterday there were two changes. I was wondering.
Who overall, they had to use only 13 players.
Yeah. Did I sleep before?
Which is quite possible because after 5 hours, in the first 20 of the 5 hours. You know where the match was headed.
Yeah. So, I mean, I see the challenge now is that, Mumbai has covered pretty much all corners. And for me, the most important part of the Mumbai team this time is they acquired one bowler from outside, from another team.
Yes.
They brought in another bowler. They brought another bowler, Pattinson. To the point where last year's match winner is actually not even shown his face. Like Hindi, they say, Modi Khai Nahi Hua Uska Abhi. Mitch McLennan is sitting where? I don't know. We have not even seen him till now.
Seen him at all.
Yeah. So, see, this is the beauty of the way the franchise is working.
Now, not for nothing. They are champions for 4 years.
Yeah. You can agree with it, disagree with it, but then that is the fact. So, I wouldn't be surprised if all of these fellows might go for another two wins. And then all of these fellows suddenly will appear in matches.
Exactly.
So, which is not a bad idea, actually.
And they have a huge... I mean, yesterday itself, Rohit Sharma clearly said that Coulter-Lyle is being tried because they want to keep other players fresh.
Yeah, yeah.
In the case of Pattinson, they want to try the bench strength, everything. They are just experimenting. There is no real need for a change. That is how well-placed they are right now. KKR has a huge problems.
I feel it is just a question of... I don't know. I mean, see, now one of the things which I noticed that if you look at other coaches, you see a lot of them outside, right? I mean, whether you look at KKR, everybody is sitting down. Whether you look at SRH, even VVS, from Lakshman to Murali to, I don't know who else, everybody is waiting.
Brad Haddon.
Yeah. In MI, you see this Mahila Jayawardhane is sitting in one corner.
He's tucked away somewhere inside.
Yeah, then you don't see anybody else because they still have a huge team, right? They have...
Zahir Khan shows up occasionally.
He shows up on TV, but you can't see him in the dugout.
Exactly.
So, what I feel is that they are giving that what we have been talking about all through, that instinctive captaincy, instinctive leadership is there for Rohit Sharma.
The Mumbai Indians has too much. I mean, there's such a huge thing that they can't. They don't have enough.
All of them in. Yeah, that also is there. Yeah, but then I like that part. I am liking because I am liking the fact that even yesterday you saw Rohit Sharma was his own person. I mean, when he was field placings and the bowling changes and all, he was just sort of following his instinct at whoever.
And Rahul Chahar was mighty impressive. Very impressive. Yeah, I mean, he actually won the match. He set it up clearly.
Yeah.
Those two wickets and the way he bowled.
Was
brilliant to watch.
Again, Rohit Sharma didn't come and say, do this, do that. I mean, he was allowing Rahul Chahar to
do what he wanted. The team is on autopilot.
That's the point. No, not just that. You go when you are needed. See, I have a theory here, very simple theory. When you are taking...
You said it in another one of our... Don't fix it
This is people management, leadership skills, because that is something which I also do. I say this thing. See, when as a leader, it is my instinct to go and
speak beyond the ears of everybody, the players.
In other people's ears, it is not their need. I need to remember it is my need more than their need. I mean, I need to sort of work with their needs. What are their needs? I need to observe carefully, find out, and go when I'm needed to go. And that is where I feel Rohit Sharma has a has an edge in short white ball.
Because, I mean, I'm not saying Rohit Sharma's captaincy is bad or bad. It is just that this Mumbai Indians team doesn't need that. I mean, even without any leader.
I'll disagree. It is this team that doesn't need it. Rohit Sharma has been captain for 5-6 years.
Yeah. See, if you take out the Mumbai Indians batting, the top five batsmen, has scored beyond 150, which is not the case with any other team in this IPL.
Bala, my point is you work towards creating that team.
Yeah, exactly. Just Rohit Sharma alone.
Because
they are victorious, we are reading too much into his captaincy.
No. I feel it is true. I feel Rohit Sharma is a guy. See, he has done that with the Indian team also. I've been saying this for quite some time. See, Virat Kohli, I am not saying Virat Kohli is a bad captain. I feel Rohit Sharma, he's a bit like Dhoni. Dhoni is not in your ear when it is not required.
He can't because he's a wicketkeeper anyway.
Not just that. Even then, he just needs to sort of see. They will listen to him. Even today, like yesterday, I was just going through this thing. I saw this heartfelt tweet from Jasprit Bumrah for Dhoni. I think it came when Dhoni had retired. I mean, you can actually make out it is coming from that deep within him.
So, always do that because you always see heartfelt tweets from Harbhajan or Yuvraj when it is with Saurav Ganguly.
Yeah.
So, it always, you are always kind of indebted to the person whom you feel has done a bit for you within the team.
I know.
So, that is always the case.
And that learning, whatever Harbhajan and this guy is, I mean, whatever they have learned from Ganguly sort of stays with them, right? See, that is leadership for you. Not that you sort of push the envelope too much to be you becoming in the limelight. That is where I see the difference.
The show, we kind of decided that we will not talk much about last night's match. And
We didn't.
But we have gotten into a very serious discussion and we have disagreed, which is absolutely fine, which is great. But we decided that we will not talk about last night's match, which is what we are doing.
No, we didn't know.
Yeah.
We have not done. See, again, I'm disagreeing.
We are taken off.
I'm saying whatever you're seeing in a team, it's like a corporation. That corporation starts doing well at a certain time because of the past efforts. It's not that you just walk into the field and then start doing everything. Most importantly, you look at the core of that team, it has remained the same. So these are things which...
Corporation, you mean it as a company, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because in Chennai, in Chennai, when you say corporation, it's about municipal. Because I never seen them doing good work. I mean, Chennai has some of the best workers, corporation workers. But I'm only talking about the corporate. We call them as councillors before anybody gets me wrong.
We have councillors everywhere. The only problem with
councillors, you call them corporators, right?
Yeah.
In other places, we call them as councillors.
We have the same here also, in Bangalore also. It's
same. Every state has that. Yeah. It's just that we use different terminology.
Yeah. Anyway, so coming, I think since we have discussed since there is nothing to discuss about Mumbai, Mumbai's role in yesterday's match. So I was only interested to figure out whether...
and it is good that DiCocco is also coming into form because he had a...
I was hoping he gets a century, That would have been funny.
He had three very good matches of play. Yeah. So which is pretty good. They have covered every boxes and some more.
Yes. So now coming to today's match, we have RCB and
Royals
are clashing. I mean,
and CSK versus Delhi.
Delhi. So the first match is RCB RR. I mean, we know why that is so because obviously you can't play CSK in the afternoon. Yeah.
That will be too much on those oldies.
Yeah. It becomes very, very difficult for the oldies, and I'm sure that it could become a legal issue.
Also, CSK is yellow, would merge with the yellow, sunny yellow.
It could actually end up becoming a legal issue there because you know Dubai, Middle East, they have the law about if people are working, workers are actually sent back home if the temperature goes up beyond a point.
Oh, okay.
So, so that happens in the Middle East. So, I mean, happens as a rule.
By the way, why do we keep saying Middle East? It is not for Middle East for us. That's for America, no?
I know. So we find it very difficult to call it West Asia. So we call it Middle East.
Gulf.
Yeah. So I mean,
you should be saying Gulf.
So I'll give you another example now that you are on it. Since we are digressing, might as well completely digress. We have the Wagha border and the Attari border. Right.
Yes. Yes.
Wagha is one side, Attari is on the other side.
Other side.
We still have a problem about which one is which. So we have named it Wagha border. That's all. End of story.
But you should call it Gulf. You are a Mallu. You are supposed to call it as Gulf.
Oh, yeah, that is a stereotype again.
Yeah, exactly. You better leave it.
Yeah, people have problems with me going after Sanju Samson. No, let me not go there.
We'll discuss today's match.
Anyways, I think RCB would be smarting. And RR could be smarter if they realize RCB is smarting. I'll put it that way. And do something different. Personally speaking, I would want Ben Stokes at number 3 or 4. Somebody else opening, I don't care who opens, even Uthappa, I don't care.
And I would want De Villiers certainly at number 4.
So two guys need to be at number 4. That's the story of the day. As far as that match goes.
Exactly.
DC, CSK, we need to see whether DC is, I have
how many fit players can DC throw up on the park today?
Whether Ricky Ponting will pad up, we'll just find out.
Still, you might be slightly older. That wouldn't bring the average age of DC below CSKs.
Wouldn't. And definitely the average fitness.
Certainly, yes.
But
CSK was impressive in its last match. Let's see whether they can sustain it. But I'm not very sure about this bunch.
Yeah. I would still say CSK.
Sam Curran and Jadeja up the batting order would certainly bring in the much needed urgency.
Yeah, they need to. I mean, if it's in this case, I would say the toss would become important because I don't think CSK can chase in case DC sort of does a DZ on them, which is sort of score in excess of 170, 180 runs. It becomes difficult. If they win the toss, bat first, they have a chance because Jadeja is coming to his own as a bowler. They are playing 3-4. I don't know, as many spinners as possible. So there is a chance. There is something Dhoni might be looking at it that way is what I feel.
Yeah, certainly. But still, DC has a very, very key in T20. You don't generally say that, but DC has too much too many big weapons up their sleeves. So it looks very tough for CSK, but hopefully I'm proved wrong.
Yeah. So like I said, I mean, if CSK can put, I mean, you don't know. On a given day, Watson can come good. Du Plessis has had 2-3 bad matches.
That's why we watch cricket in the first place.
T20 in the first place. Du Plessis,
Because there is always a room for the underdog.
Yeah.
CSK is, to talk CSK in terms of underdog is not right there. But still, within the context of this tournament and this particular situation, they are certainly the underdogs.
Yeah, which is why I'm saying. So, I would love to have CSK sort of eke out a win here. I would love to see that. And I would also love to see RR eke out a lead. The reason why I'm saying that also, just to sort of put things in perspective, not that I have anything against the other teams, it is to sort of bring forth this one fact that I've actually seen many of the teams sort of take things easy at some point in their games and then lose. So now we are coming to the back end, the business end of the tournament. 8 matches done. The top two teams have 12 points each, DC and MI. I logically speaking, another 2 wins and both of them should go through to the playoffs.
Which is most likely to happen.
Yes. So which basically means RCB is on 10. But then the way they played last match, they need to sort of shake that out very quickly, get back to normal. I mean, not try this.
Surely need to pull up their socks.
No more cute things. They just need to do what they are
doing. That is not cute thing, Raj. Please. That is stupid.
Whatever it is. That is what I mean. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So, don't be charitable. That's not like you.
Yeah, I know. No, for me, cute means that only. Like Dinesh Karthik's cute stroke, which actually made Rahul Chahar look like Shane Warne.
Yeah.
So.
That's true. But you
actually. Chahar did bowl well. Yeah, Chahar did bowl well, but not on that delivery, man. I mean, that was not a delivery.
Raj, your reputation is to call a spade a bloody shovel.
Yeah, I know. Not even a shovel. Now I call it a JCB.
JCB, yeah. So, better live up to it.
Yeah, yeah. So, anyway. So, what I'm
old age is blunting your cutting edge.
I know that sounds very weird, corny, actually. Yeah. So anyway, so this what I'm saying is now we'll have troublemakers. The last four, they have nothing to lose anymore.
Because they lost so much.
Yeah, they have already lost so much. I mean, imagine what is going through the Kings XI camp.
And for the now, CSK.
Yeah, for that matter, even CSK. Okay, let us now that we don't look very confident of getting there, let us spoil as many parties as possible.
Which is good for the tournament.
Yeah, that is precisely why I say why I want CSK and RR to win today. So let us see what happens.
Yeah, that's good anticipation.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just having fun. I mean, as simple as that.
Yeah, exactly.
After yesterday's match,
IPL is just fun for us.
Yeah, yes. After yesterday's match, I don't want to wake up snoring again like we did today. So I think on that note, we might say
we'll close it. Go back
we'll go back to snoring
because the weather right now in Chennai is excellent for sleep. Yeah, raining. I don't know how it is in Bangalore, Raj. But it's raining.
It's not. It is bright. It is bright and sunny in Bangalore. So
hey, the roles reversed.
Yeah, I know. So which is why I said.
I said exactly. That's what I was coming to too.
So keep watching, and we have done some special shows.
I'll put it up, Raj.
We'll post it on our YouTube channel. So go like us, watch us, join us.
Yes.
Have fun. And by the way, this is not just about IPL. We are just doing IPL because that's the flavor of the season. Going forward, Bits and Banter is about we make a song
everything
and about everything.
Whatever we
see. And what we don't see, obviously, we don't see. So we'll leave it there.
Perhaps we'll talk very elaborately about the things that we don't see because we are journalists.
Yeah. Which is what we do very well. Yeah,
very well, exactly. give opinion on stuff that we have no clue about.
Yes. So thank you very much. Thank you for watching and have a good day. Stay safe and we'll see you later this evening. Doubleheader coming up. So we'll see you later this evening.
Bye.
Bye-bye.